mercy on us, O God the Father, Father, Creator, Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord God, host be with us in our help and our hearts and tribulations of you, O Lord. Make us worthy to pray, thankfully, our Father who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Stay our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil. In Christ Jesus our Lord, for thine is the kingdom, power, and glory, and the worship of Christ and Holy Spirit. For you have come and said, bless me, it's absent, forgive me. Let us give thanks to the beneficent and merciful God, the Father of our Lord, God and Savior Jesus Christ. For he has covered us, helped us, guarded us, accepted us to himself, spared us, supported us, and brought us to this hour. Let us also ask him, the Lord our God, the Pentecostor, to guard us in all peace this holy day, and all the days of our life.
Let us pray, Lord, have mercy.
O Master, Lord God, the Pentecostor, the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, we thank you for everything, concerning everything and in everything. For you have covered us, helped us, guarded us, accepted us to yourself, spared us, supported us, and brought us to this hour.
Pray that God may have mercy and compassion on us. Hear us, help us, and accept us supplications and prayers of his saints. For thou just going on our behalf at all times, and forgive us our sins, Lord, have mercy.
Therefore we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind, grant us to complete this holy day, and all the days of our life, and all peace with thee, or fear all envy, all temptation, all the work of Satan, the counsel we command arising up of enemies, hidden and manifest, take them away from us and from all your people, and from this church, and from this your holy place. But those things which are good and profitable do provide for us, for as you have given us the authority to tread on serpents and scorpions, and upon all the power of the enemy.
Lord have mercy, O come let us worship the Holy Trinity, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Peace be with all.
And with your spirit.
Again, let us ask God the Pentecostor, the Father of our Lord, God and Savior Jesus Christ. We ask and entreat your goodness, O Lord of mankind. Remember, O Lord, the sick among your people.
Lord, have mercy.
You have visited them with mercies and compassion. Heal them. Take away from them and from us every sickness and every malady. The spirit of sickness chase away. Those who are long-lived maladies raise up in comfort. Those who are afflicted by unclean spirits set them all free. Those who are imprisoned or done in those who are in exile captivity. Those who are held in bitter bondage, Lord, set them all free and have mercy upon them. For you are he who loosens the bound and lifteth the fallen. The hope of those who have no hope and the help of those who have no helper. The comfort of the faint heart, the harbor of those in the storm. All souls that are distressed or bound, grant them mercy, Lord, grant them rest, grant them refreshment, grant them grace, grant them help, grant them salvation, grant them the forgiveness of their sins and their iniquities. Ask for us too, Lord, the sicknesses of our souls heal and those of our bodies are cure. O you, the true physician of our souls and bodies, the bishop of all flesh, visit us with your salvation.
Lord, have mercy.
We ask and entreat your goodness, love of mankind. Remember, Lord, the sacrifice, the offering, and the thanks of those who offer them to the honor and glory of your holy name.
Lord, have mercy.
Receive them upon your holy rational altar in heaven as a sweet savor incense before your greatness in heaven to the service of your holy angels and archangels. As you have received the gifts of the righteous, able to sacrifice of Abraham and the two mites of the widow, so also receive the thank offering of your servants, those in abundance and those in scarcity, hidden and manifest, those who desire to offer to but have none, and those who offer these gifts to you this very day. Give them the incorruptible instead of the corruptible, the heavenly instead of the earthy, the eternal instead of the temporal, their houses and their store, fill them with all good things. Remember, Lord, surround them, Lord, by the power of your holy angels and archangels, as they have remembered your holy name on earth. Remember them also in your kingdom and in this age too. Leave them not behind.
Lord, have mercy. Let us pray the angels sing. Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, and goodwill toward men. We praise you, we bless you, we serve you, we worship you, we confess you, we glorify you, give thanks to you for your glory. Lord, heavenly King, God the Father, Holy Creator. Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, take away the sin of the world, receive our prayers. As you sit at our hand, this Father, have mercy on us. You holy for the holy Jesus, Lord Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit. Glory to God the Father, amen. Every day I'll bless you and praise you on your hand, for our unto age of all ages, amen. The night season my soul looks unto you, my God, for your peace are right upon the earth. I was meant to get on your words, for you have become a helper unto me. Every day same for you shall see me. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortals, born virgin, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortals, good fire for us, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortals, those of the dead, send heavens, have mercy on us. Glory be to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and to the age of all ages, amen. Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. 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 Lord, forgive us our sins. Lord, forgive us our iniquities. Lord, forgive us our trespasses. O Lord, visit sick people who have been forsaken in thy name. Our Father, and mother, and fallen asleep, Lord, pull their souls. You are out of sin, have mercy on us. Or you are out of sin, help us with justification. Yours, glory, and then to the Lord, and his Lord, have mercy on us. Bless us, amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses. As we forgive those trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. In Christ Jesus, our Lord, grant us the divine work of God. In Christ Jesus, our Lord, amen. Hail to be asked, you, saint, full of glory, the ever-virgin, the faithless mother of Christ. Lift up our prayers, she brought us on the earth, give us our sins. Hail to the only bearing, you have brought forth, unto us, to thy Christ, our Lord God. Ask not on behalf of the ever-virgin, our soul, and give us our sins. O Virgin Mary, all the earth, close to God, give for all mankind. And if you on behalf of Christ, you will bring, give us our sins. Hail to you, O Virgin, the right and true Queen. Hail to the pride of our race, who bore to us Emmanuel.
We ask you to remember us, O our faithful advocate, for our Lord Jesus Christ, that he may forgive us our sins.
Blessed are you, Mary, the wise and the chaste, the second tabernacle, the spiritual treasure,
the pure turtle dove, who declared in our land and brought unto us the fruit of the Spirit.
The Spirit of consolation came upon your Son on the waters of the Jordan, of which Noah was a type.
For that dove has proclaimed glad tidings. Tidings to us, the peace of God for mankind.
Likewise, you, our hope, the spiritual turtle dove, have brought mercy unto us, carrying him in your womb.
He is is Jesus, the begotten of the Father. He was born of you unto us, setting free our race.
Therefore, let us declare first with our hearts, then also with our tongues, proclaiming and saying,
O our Lord Jesus Christ, make for yourself within us a temple of your Holy Spirit, glorifying you.
Hail to O Virgin, the right and true Queen, hail to the pride of our race, who bore to us Emmanuel.
We ask you to remember us, O our people, advocate before our Lord Jesus Christ, that he may forgive us our sin.
Hail to our Father Paul, teacher of the world, hail to the chosen vessel of our Savior.
Pray to the Lord on our behalf, O blessed Saint, our teacher Paul the Apostle, that he may forgive us our sin.
Hail to you, O martyr, hail to the evangelist, hail to the apostle, Mark the beholder of God.
Pray to the Lord on our behalf, O beholder of God, the evangelist, Mark the apostle, that he may forgive us our sin.
Watch over us from on high where you dwell, O Lady of us, all the ever virgin, the Otoko.
Ask of him whom you have borne, our good Savior, to take away our troubles and grant us his peace.
Hail to you, O Virgin, the right and true Queen, to the pride of our race, who bore to us Emmanuel.
We ask you to remember us, O our faithful advocate, before our Lord Jesus Christ, that he may forgive us our sins.
We exalt you, Mother of the true Lord, glorify you, Saint Theotokos, who brought forth unto us, save all the world, came and saved our souls. Glory be to your Master, King, Christ, your Father, the Apostle, the Father, the
Most, the Father, the Most, the Father, the Most, the Father, the Most, the May the Lord fulfill all of God, have mercy upon us. Settle your mercy upon us. Have compassion upon us. Hear us. Bless us, keep us, and help us. Take away your anger from us, visit us with your salvation, and forgive us our sin.
Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Pray.
Stand up for prayer.
Peace be with all.
And with your spirit.
O Master, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, who said to us in the honored disciples and holy apostles, many prophets and righteous men have desired to see the things which you see and are not seeing them, and to hear the things which you hear and have not heard them. But as for you, blessed are your eyes, so they see, and your ears, so they hear. May we be worthy to hear and to act according to all the Gospels. Do the prayers of your saints. Also our Master, all those who have been in us, to remember them in our supplications and prayers, which we offer unto you, Lord our God. Those who are already fallen asleep, repose in those who are sick, heal them. We are the life of us all, the salvation of us all, the hope of us all, the healing of us all, and the resurrection of us all. And unto you,
Amen. Amen.
Let Lord, is hear the holy gospel.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord of power. Bless the Lord, the reading of the holy gospel according to St. John.
Stand in the fear of God and listen to the gospel, a reading from the gospel according to our teacher, St. John the Evangelist. May his blessings be with Solomon from the Psalms, our teacher David, the prophet and king. May his blessings be with us, Solomon. Blessed be the Lord forevermore. Amen and amen. Lord, where are your former loving kindnesses, which you swore to David in your truth? Alleluia. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, our Lord God, Savior and King of us all, Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, to whom be glory forever. Amen. Then Jesus cried out and said, he who believes in me believes not in me, but in him who sent me. And he who sees me sees him who sent me. I have come as a light into the world, that whoever believes in me should not abide in darkness. And if anyone hears my word and does not believe, I do not judge him, for I did not come to judge the world, but to save the world. He who rejects me and does not receive my words has that which judges him. The word that I have spoken will judge him in the last day. For I have not spoken on my own authority, but the Father who sent me gave me a command what I should say and what I should speak. And I know that his command is everlasting life. Therefore, whatever I speak, just as the Father has told me, so I speak.
Glory be to God forever.
Lord, make us worthy to pray thankfully, our Father who art in heaven.
Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Indeed,
it is not temptation, but mercy, Lord. Christ Jesus, our Lord,
in Christ Jesus, our Lord.
I rise to the Lord.
Before you, O Lord.
Let us attend on the fear of God. Amen.
Peace be with all. O Master, Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of the Father, who has broken every bond of sin to his saving, life-giving suffering, who breathed into the face of his saintly disciples and holy apostles and said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. Now, so Master, you have given grace to all the apostles, to those who are timely and peace in your holy church, to forgive sin upon the earth and bind and loose every bond of iniquity now. So we ask and entreat your goodness, Lord, mankind, for your servants, my fathers, my brethren, my weakness, we who bow our heads before your holy glory. Dispense to us your mercy. Loose every bond of sin. If we committed any sin against you, knowingly or unknowingly, or through anguish of heart, whether indeed or word or through faintheartedness, the Master knows the weakness of man as a good one, lover of mankind. Grant us the forgiveness of our sins. Bless us, purify us, absolve us, and all your people. Fill us with your fear and strengthen us for your holy good will. For due unto you is glory and honor, dominion, worship, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever and at the age of all ages. Amen.
Amen. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Proclaim and say, O our Lord Jesus Christ, bless the air of heaven, bless the waters of the river, bless the sea and the herbs. May your mercy and your peace be a fortress unto your people. Save us and have mercy on us. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, bless us. Amen. Bless me. Bless me. Love the repentance. Forgive me. Say the blessing.
O Christ our God.
Amen. So be.
O King of peace, grant us your peace, establish us your peace, and forgive us our sins. For yours the power, the glory, the blessing, the might forever. Amen. Lord, make us worthy to pray thankfully, our Father who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Done on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Temptation, deliver us from evil one. Christ Jesus our Lord, for thine is the kingdom, power, and glory forever. Amen. May the love of God the Father, the grace of his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, the communion gift of the Holy Spirit, be with you all.
And with your spirit.
If everyone can pray one psalm from the third hour and one psalm from the sixth hour from the prayer books in front of you. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, amen. And the glory be to the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and ever, and to the age of all ages, amen. Glory be to the Father. The praise and prayer of the third and the sixth hour of the blessed day is offered to Christ, beseeching him to forgive our sins. From the psalms of our father David, the prophet and king, may his blessings be with us all, amen. Give this amount, holy, 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 the gospel according to our teacher, St. John. May his blessings be with us all, amen.
By the help of the Holy Spirit, and the Father will send in my name. He will teach all things to remembrance, all things I said to you. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Not as the world gives, do I give to you. Let not your heart be troubled, and let it be afraid. Yet from me, say to him, going, coming back to you. If you love me, you would rejoice what I said. I'm going to the Father, for my Father is greater than I. Now I've told you before it comes, that when it does come to pass, you may believe. I will no longer take one to through, for the world, this world is coming, and he is nothing in me. All men know I love the Father, as the Father gave me command, so I do. Rise, let us go from here. I am the true vine, and my Father's vine dresser. Every branch that is being not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears more fruit, and burns that bear more fruit. You are already clean, because the words are spoken to you by me, and I knew.
Glory be to God forever. May the saints of God fill in peace. We worship you, Christ, good Father and Holy Spirit. For you come and save us. Have mercy on us, your Holy Spirit, the Lord, whom you send forth upon your holy disciples and honor apostles of the third hour. Do not take him away from us, the good one, but renew him within us. Create in me a clean heart, O God, renew a right spirit within me. Do not cast me away from your presence, and do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O Lord, who sent down your Holy Spirit upon your holy disciples and honored apostles the third hour, do not take him away from us, O good one, but we ask you to renew within us, O Lord, Jesus Christ, Son of God, the Word, the riot and life-giving spirit, the spirit of prophecy and chastity, the spirit of holiness, righteousness, and authority. O the Almighty One, for you are the light of our souls. O he gives light to every man who comes to the world, have mercy on us.
Now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
O Theotokos, you are the true vine aboard the cluster of life. We ask you, O full of grace, through the apostles, for the salvation of our souls. Blessed is the Lord our God. Blessed is the Lord day by day. He prepares our way. For he is the God of our salvation.
Now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
O heavenly King, the comforter of the Spirit of truth, who is present in all places and fills all, the treasury of good things and the life giver, graciously come and dwell in us and purify us from all defilement, O good one, and save our souls.
Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
Just as you were with your disciples, O Savior, and gave them peace, graciously come also and be with us, and grant us your peace, and save us and deliver our souls.
Now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Whenever we stand in your holy sanctuary, we are considered standing in heaven. O Theotokos, you are the gate of heaven. Open for us the gate of mercy.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy mortals, born of the Virgin, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortals, crucified for us, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy immortal, who rose from the dead and ascended to heaven, have mercy on us. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and in the ages of all ages. Amen. Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us.
O Holy Trinity, have mercy on us.
O Lord, forgive us our sins. O Lord, forgive us our iniquities. O Lord, forgive us our trespasses. O Lord, for the sake of your people, heal them for the sake of your holy name. Our fathers and brethren have fallen asleep. O Lord, repose their souls. You are without sin, Lord, have mercy on us.
Without sin, Lord, help us and receive our supplications. Yours is the glory, dominion, and holiness. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Love us. Lord, make us worthy to pray thankfully, our Father who art in heaven. Glory be to God, holy, 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 the gospel according to our teacher, St. Matthew. May his blessings be with us all, amen.
And seeing the multitudes, he went up on a mountain, and when he was seated, his disciples came to him. Then he opened his mouth and taught him, saying, Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are those who are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they shall be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they shall see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called sons of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they revile and persecute you and say all kinds of evil against you falsely for my sake. Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for your great reward is in heaven. For so they persecuted the prophets who were before you. You are the salt of the earth, but if the salt loses its flavor, how shall it be seasoned? It is then good for nothing to be thrown out and trampled underfoot by men. You are the light of the world, a city that is on a hill that cannot be hidden. Nor the day light a lamp and put it under a basket, but on a lampstand, and it gives light to all around the house. Let your light shine before men, that they may see your good works and glorify your Father in heaven.
Glory be to God forever. May the saints of God fill in peace. We worship you, Christ, with your Father and Holy Spirit. For you have come and saved us. Have mercy on us. O you who on the sixth day and in the sixth hour is nailed to the cross for the sin which our father Adam dared to commit in paradise, tear the handwriting of our sins, O Christ our God, and save us. I cry to God, and the Lord heard me. God, hear my prayer. Do not refuse my petition. Be attentive to me and hear me in the evening and in the morning and at midday. I say my words and hears my voice and delivers my soul in peace.
Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
O Jesus Christ, our God, who is nailed to the cross in the sixth hour, and killed sin by the tree, and by your death you made alive the dead man whom you created with your own hands and had died in sin. Put to death our pains by your healing and life-giving passions, and by the nails which you were nailed. Rescue our minds from thoughtlessness of earthly deeds and worldly lusts, to the remembrance of your heavenly commandments according to your compassion.
Now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Since we have no favor, nor excuse, nor justification because of our many sins, we through you implore him who was born of you, Theotokos, the Virgin, for abundant and acceptable is your intercession with our Savior. O Holy Mother, do not exclude us sinners from your intercession with him we bore, for he is merciful, able to save us, because he suffered for us to deliver us. Let your compassion speedily reach us, for exceedingly humbled. Help us, O God, our Savior, for the glory of your name. O Lord, deliver us, and forgive us our sins for the sake of your holy name.
Now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
You wrought salvation in the midst of all the earth, O Christ our God, as you stretch your holy hands on the cross. Therefore all nations cry out, saying, glory be to you, O Lord.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
We worship your incorruptible person, O good one, asking for the forgiveness of our sins, O Christ our God, for of your will you were pleased to be lifted up onto the cross to deliver those whom you created from the bondage of the enemy. We cry out unto you and give thanks to you, for you have filled all with joy, O Savior, when you came to help the world. Lord, glory be to you.
Now and ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
You are she who is full of grace, O Theotokos, the Virgin. We praise you. We, for through the cross of your Son, Hades fell down and death was abolished. We were dead, but we are raised and became worthy of eternal life and gained the delight of the first paradise. Therefore, we thankfully glorify the immortal Christ our God.
We exalt you, Mother, the true light. We glorify you, Saint Theotokos, for brought forth unto us, saved the whole world, who came and saved our souls. Glory be to our Master, our King, Christ, the pride of the apostles, the crown of the martyrs, joy of the righteous, the furnace of the church, of the innocents. We pray for the Holy Trinity.
We believe in one God, God the Father, the Pentecostor, creator of heaven and earth and all things seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God, begotten, not created, of one essence of the Father, by whom all things are made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit, and of the Virgin Mary, and became man. And he was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, suffered and buried, and the third day rose from the dead according to the Scriptures. Ascended into the heavens, he sits at the right hand of his Father.
He's coming in his glory, judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. Yes, we believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father.
The Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified.
He spoke by the prophets, one holy Catholic apostolic church. We confess our baptism and glory and our sins.
We look for the resurrection of the dead and life the age to come. Amen.
O Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world, hear us, have mercy on us, and forgive us our sins. Amen.
Yeah.
lead us not into temptation, deliver us from evil one in Christ Jesus our Lord, with thine kingdom and power and glory forever.
Glory and honor, honor and glory to the all-holy Trinity, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Peace, remember, O Lord, the peace and edification of the one only holy Catholic Apostolic Church of God. Amen. Remember, O Lord, those who have brought unto you these gifts, those in whose behalf they have been brought and those by whom they have been brought, give them all the heavenly reward.
Amen.
Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, amen. Blessed be God, the Father, the Pontocrator.
Amen.
Blessed be His only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Amen. One is the Holy Father. One is the Holy Son, one is the Holy Spirit, amen. Blessed be the Lord God forever, amen. Praise the Lord, all you Gentiles. Lord, him, all you peoples, for his mercy has been striking towards us, and the truth of the Lord endures forever, amen. Alleluia.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever.
Of guest, our
seater, ye nepasi,
et omnemotis.
Let us give thanks to the beneficent and merciful God, the Father of our Lord, God and Savior Jesus Christ. For he has covered us, helped us, guarded us, accepted us to himself, spared us, supported us, and brought us to this hour. Let us also ask him, the Lord our God, the Pontocrator, to guard us in all peace this holy day and all the days of our life.
Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Oh, Master, Lord, God the Pontocrator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, we thank you for everything, concerning everything, and in everything. We have covered us, helped us, guarded us, accepted us yourself, spared us, supported us, and brought us to this hour.
Pray that God may have mercy and compassion on us. Hear us, help us, and accept the supplications and prayers of his saints for that which is good on our behalf at all times, and make us worthy to partake of the communion of his holy and blessed mysteries for the remission of our sins.
Lord, have mercy.
Therefore, we ask and entreat your goodness, O lover of mankind. Grant us to complete this holy day in all the days of our life, in all peace with your fear, all envy, all temptation, all the work of Satan, the counsel we command arising up of enemies hidden and manifest. Take them away from us and from all your people, and from this table and from this your holy place. But those things which are good and profitable do provide for us. For it is you giving us the authority to tread on serpents and scorpions and upon all the power of the enemy. May your servants, the minister, the Higgins, the priests, the deacons, the clergy, and all your people be absolved from the mouth of the Holy Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, from the mouth of one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, from the mouth of 12 apostles, from the mouth of the beholder of God, the evangelist Mark, the holy apostle and martyr, the patriarch, Saint Severus, our teacher, the Oscar, Saint Athanasius, the apostolic, Saint Peter, the holy martyr and high priest, Saint John Chrysostom, Saint Cyril, Saint Basil, and Saint Gregory, from the mouth of the 318 of Semenicea, 150 of Constantinople, the 200 of Ephesus, and from the mouth of Blessed Honor Father, the Patriarch Pope Abbatuedris II, and from my own mouth being the Lethe, for blessed and full of glory is your holy name, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of all ages. Amen.
Of your God. Paul the Apostle, appoint to the Gospel of God, a reading from the Epistle of our teacher Paul to the Hebrews. May his blessings be upon us. Amen. Therefore, holy brethren, partakers of the heavenly calling, consider the apostle and high priest of our confession, Christ Jesus, who was faithful to him who appointed him, as Moses also was faithful in all his house. For this one has been counted worthy of more glory than Moses, inasmuch as he who built the house has more honor than the house. For every house is built by someone, but he who built all things is God. And Moses indeed was faithful in all his house as a servant, for a testimony of those things which would be spoken afterward. But Christ as a son over his own house, whose house we are if we hold fast the confidence and the rejoicing of the hope firm to the end. Therefore, as the Holy Spirit says, today if you will hear his voice, do not harden your hearts, as in the rebellion, in the day of trial in the wilderness, where your fathers tested me, tried me, and saw my works 40 years. Therefore I was angry with that generation, and said, they always go astray in their heart, and they have not known my ways. So I swore in my wrath, they shall not enter my rest. Beware, brethren, lest there be in any of you an evil heart of unbelief in departing from the living God. But exhort one another daily, while it is called today, lest any of you be hardened through the deceitfulness of sin. For we have become partakers of Christ if we hold the beginning of our confidence steadfast to the end, while it is said, today, if you will hear his voice, do not harden your hearts as in the rebellion. For who, having heard, rebelled? Indeed, was it not all who came out of Egypt led by Moses? Now with whom was he angry 40 years? Was it not with those who sinned, with corpses fell in the wilderness? And to whom did he swear that they would not enter his rest, but to those who did not obey? So we see that they could not enter in because of unbelief. For indeed the gospel was preached to us as well as to them, but the word which they heard did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in those who heard it. The grace of God the Father be with you all. Amen.
Reading from the epistle of our teacher Jude. May his blessings be with us all. Amen. Now Enoch the seventh from Adam prophesied about these men also, saying, behold, the Lord comes with 10,000s of his saints to execute judgment on all, to convict all who are ungodly among them of all their ungodly deeds which they have committed in an ungodly way, and of all the harsh things which ungodly sinners have spoken against him. These are grumblers, complainers, walking according to their own lusts, and they mouth great swelling words, flattering people to gain advantage. But you, beloved, remember the words which were spoken before by the apostles of our Lord Jesus Christ, how they told you that there would be mockers in the last time who would walk according to their own ungodly lusts. These are sensual persons who cause divisions, not having the Spirit. But you, beloved, building yourselves up on your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit, keep yourselves in the love of God, looking for the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ unto eternal life. On some have compassion, making a distinction, but others save with fear, pulling them out of the fire, hating even the garment defiled by the flesh. Now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling and to present you faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy, to God our Savior, who alone is wise, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forever. Amen. No love of the world or the things in the world passes away in its desires, but he who does the will of God shall abide forever. Amen.
Yeah. reading from the Acts of our fathers, the pure apostles who were invested with the grace of the Holy Spirit. May their blessing be upon us all. Amen. Now on the first day of the week, when the disciples came together to break bread, Paul, ready to depart the next day, spoke to them and continued his message until midnight. There were many lamps in the upper room where they were gathered together, and in a window sat a certain young man named Eutychus, who was sinking into a deep sleep. He was overcome by sleep, and as Paul continued speaking, he fell down from the third story and was taken up dead. But Paul went down, fell on him, and embracing him said, "Do not trouble yourselves, for his life is in him." Now when he had come up, had broken bread and eaten, and talked a long while, even till daybreak, he departed. And they brought the young man in alive, and they were not a little comforted. Then we went ahead to the ship and sailed to Assos, there intending to take Paul on board, for so he had given orders, intending himself to go on foot. And when he met us at Assos, we took him on board and came to Mytilene. We sailed from there, and the next day came opposite Chios. The following day we arrived at Samos and stayed at Trogyllium. The next day we came to Miletus. For Paul had decided to sail past Ephesus so that he would not have to spend time in Asia, for he was hurrying to be at Jerusalem, if possible, on the day of Pentecost. The word of the Lord shall grow, multiply, be mighty, and be confirmed in the Holy Church of God. Amen.
In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, amen. Today is the 17th day of the blessed month of Amshir. May God end it in goodness and renew it for us in peace and tranquility, while our sins and iniquities are forgiven through the tender mercies of my Lord, O my fathers, and my brethren. On this day, Saint Mina the monk was martyred. This saint was born in Achmim to Christian parents who were farmers since his youth. His heart was inclined to renounce the world, so he became a monk. For a period of time, he fasted 2 days at a time. When the Arabs ruled the country, Saint Mina heard that they denied that God had a son from his nature and essence, and equal with him in eternity. This denial of faith was painful to the saint, so he took permission from the abbot of the monastery and went to El Ashmumin, and he came before the commander of the Arab camp and asked him, "Is it true that you say that God has no son from his nature and essence?" The commander replied, saying, "We deny that saying about God and totally reject it." The saint told the Arab commander that our belief is that the Lord Christ is God of God and light of light. The commander replied, "In our faith, this is blasphemy." The saint told him that the Bible says, "He who believes in the Son has everlasting life, and he who does not believe in the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abides in him." The commander became enraged at this and ordered his soldiers to torture the saint and threw him into the sea. The believers gathered his body, shrouded and buried it, and they arranged a commemoration of Saint Mina the monk on this day. May his prayers be with us, and glory be to God forever. Amen. Peace be with all.
And with your spirit.
O Master, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, who said to his saintly honored disciples and holy apostles, "Many prophets and righteous men have desired to see the things which you see and have not seen them, and to hear the things which you hear and have not heard them. But as for you, blessed are your eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear." May we be worthy to hear and to act according to holy gospels. through the prayers of your saints.
Pray for the Holy Gospel.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember also our Master, all those who have been in us, to remember them in our supplications and prayers, which we offer unto you, Lord our God. Those already fallen asleep, repose them. Those who are sick, heal them. For you are the life of us all, the salvation of us all, the hope of us all, the healing of us all, and the resurrection of us all.
The Psalm of David, hallelujah.
I will sing of the mercies of the Lord forever. With my mouth will I make known your faithfulness. For who in the heavens can be compared to the Lord? Who among the sons of the mighty can be likened to the Lord?
The fear of God, and let us hear the holy gospel.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord of powers. Bless, O Lord, the reading of the holy gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Labor for the food which perishes, but for the food which endures to everlasting life, which the Son of Man will give you, because God the Father has sent his seal on him. Then they said to him, what shall we do that we may work the works of God? Jesus answered and said to them, this is the work of God, that you believe in him whom he sent. Therefore, they said to him, what sign will you perform then that we may see it and believe you? What work will you do? Our fathers ate the manna in the desert. As it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat. Then Jesus said to them, most assuredly I say to you, Moses did not give you the bread from heaven, but my Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is he who comes down from heaven and gives life to the world. Then they said to him, Lord, give us this bread always. And Jesus said to them, I am the bread of life. He who comes to me shall never hunger, and he who believes in me shall never thirst. But I said to you that you have seen me and yet do not believe. All that the Father gives me will come to me, and the one who comes to me I will by no means cast out. For I have come down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of him who sent me. This is the will of the Father who sent me, that of all he has given me I should lose nothing, but should raise it up at the last day. And this is the will of him who sent me, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have everlasting life, and I will raise him up at the last day. The Jews then complained about him because he said, I am the bread which came down from heaven. And they said, is this not Jesus, the son of Joseph, whose father and mother we know? How is it then that he says, I have come down from heaven? Jesus therefore answered and said to them, do not murmur among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day. It is written in the prophets, and they shall all be taught by God. Therefore, everyone who has heard and learned from the Father comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except he who is from God, he has seen the Father. Glory is due to our God to the age of all ages. Amen.
Glory be to God forever.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, amen. So, right before we start the sermon, let's start with just where we picked off in the explanation of the liturgy. So again, if you miss any of these or need a refresher, just refer to the website under the videos, under that icon, and you'll see all the explanations. I think we're in the 80s, the 80th one of explanation. So we're close to the end. So again, big picture, if you want to divide the liturgy, divide it into three different parts, right? The preparation, the liturgy of the word, and the liturgy of the faithful. So preparation is what we do the day before with vespers, the matins in the morning, and then the offering as well. The liturgy of the word is what we're just finishing right now, where we receive the word of God. The climax, of course, is the gospel. So the gospel gives us the message of the day, and we meditate upon it in the sermon, picking something specifically about that. And all the readings are revolving around the gospel. Then we are ready because we receive the word of God, our first communion, then we're ready to pray, right? Which is what we're going to do after the sermon, the liturgy of the faithful. And it's divided into the different parts of the great litanies where we pray for the peace of the church, the fathers, the assemblies. We pray that we have peace with God, peace within us, and peace with others as well. Because we can't continue in prayer unless we first make peace. Then we have the anaphora, raising up ourselves, where we join the liturgy that's always ongoing in heaven with all the angels and saying, holy, holy, holy. Then we have the whole story of salvation, reminding us, why are we here? From the garden to his crucifixion, the garden, incarnation, crucifixion, resurrection, ascension, and sending us the Holy Spirit as well. Then we have the institution narrative where we ask the Holy Spirit to come upon the bread and wine to make it his body and blood. And then the prayers, the different prayers that we all should pray every single liturgy. Then we are at this part here with the commemoration of saints. And we're going one by one on who we're commemorating. And I know it's a long list. So I encourage you to remember one or two and maybe just focus on some of the highlights of their lives. So we are now on this great saint, Saint John. St. John the Short, or St. John Colobus, and he was a Higuman. So he was a spiritual brother of St. Bishoy, which we'll talk about also next week, and he was a disciple of Abba Pemwa. And I know, like, before I go on, this will sound very, very strict and very, like, almost unloving, all right? But what they do in the monastery is not the same, kind of like, we don't have the standards of the monastery. So we cannot judge what they do in the monastery, all right? So let me just preface that before continuing the story. So he was basically, to enter, you have to get permission of the abbot. And the abbot saw him and he was reluctant. And then an angel appeared to him and he said, look, he's a chosen vessel of mine, let him in. So he put on the monastic garb on St. John. And then he tested him, right? He hit him for 7 days with palm branches. And then, and what's St. John's reaction? I have sinned. Even though, like, he just hit him, he's testing him, right? And this for us, you know, we'd call the police, 911, and this is a test. This is between a father and his spiritual son. So again, that's why we cannot judge what they do in the monastery. So he's testing him. And then he tests them, and basically he saw that in a vision, this Abba Pinwa, he saw a vision of an angel giving St. John 7 crowns. What were the 7 crowns? The 7 times he was beaten. So for us, we see terrible. In the eyes of God, crowns. Crowns. So again, we don't judge. We don't judge because we don't have the full picture. Then the greatest test that we probably know the story of, which he's most famous for, is the testing that he gave him, an incredible test that I don't think anybody here would do, which is basically he said, go take this piece of wood and go all the way to the water, which was 12 miles away. walking, right? 12 miles. Go there twice a day and water this piece of wood. Like, we wouldn't even go half a mile to maybe plant a beautiful tree, let alone a piece of wood. But obedience. We see his simplicity and obedience, and he did it twice a day. I think it was for 3 years. For 3 years. And this piece of wood, if you know anything about biology or whatever, a piece of wood cannot just become a tree. And it produced fruits. And this fruit, basically, this father of Manasseh, the abbot, said, look at the fruits of obedience to everybody. So that's what he's famous for. He heard lots of praises and smells of incense when he was praying because of his holiness. And he even saw some angels fanning him in the sun, just keeping him cool. So he's known, again, when we say this, remember the aspect of obedience, simplicity, and just being humble. Like, somebody hits you and you say, I've sinned, when you did nothing. It shows all these great, great aspects of this great saint. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, amen. Good morning, everyone. Good to see you on this lovely, beautiful sunshine day. So as we know, as we mentioned 3 weeks ago, we are in the last month before we enter the Great Fast. So we see that the church is preparing us, right? Last month, the church was preparing us by talking about baptism. That's the Feast of Holy Theophany, and all the readings were illumination, purification, sanctification. And all this is leading up to the Great Fast. So the church is telling us from now, start remembering your baptism. Start remembering, hey, you're purified, you're set apart. And then this month, this Coptic month, it goes into which is Amshir, talks about the Eucharist. And as we mentioned, talks about, we read the whole Gospel of John chapter 6 in the 3 weeks, including, so all the liturgy ones, and between the matins and liturgy, we read all of John chapter 6. What's John chapter 6? Well, we read it, started last week, read the feeding of the 5,000, about Jesus walking on water to get to the other side, and then they follow Jesus, and we had the first week of Amshir, where we said, look, you know, hey, did you come to see me or did you come for food? So what are you coming for? What are you investing in? And we talk about being a wise investor. And today we read the rest of the chapter where the great discourse of him saying, I am the bread of life. So Jesus is the bread of life. And as we say, when we say bread every time, it should always, always get our minds directly to the Eucharist as well. Before we get into that, what do we believe? You know, back then, a long time ago, they believed that the earth was flat. It was a belief. And everything acted according to that. In other words, they wouldn't sail too far because they would just think, boom, they just fall off. So their belief said, don't go too far because you're going to fall. Did you know that only in the 19th century, just like a couple of hundred years ago, up to then, only in the 19th century, it's still the 19th, the doctors didn't wash their hands like before surgery. They didn't believe, maybe in terms of like the cleanliness. People believe that if you eat a watermelon seed, that all of a sudden you're going to grow a watermelon in your stomach. So I don't know, anybody's mom teach them that? Just mine? Yes. Be careful of those seeds. Some people believe white cows give milk. Black and brown cows give chocolate milk. Some people believe fortune cookies really have ancient, deep-rooted Chinese, secrets. But basically, it's just an American thing just to get you, just to get you to come to Chinese at the end. And the biggest belief is some people believe that moms really have eyes in the back of their heads. Actually, this one may be true, because how else do they know what's going on all back there? That's a belief. These are all different beliefs. The readings today talk about a whole bunch of other things, and let's see what the readings focus on. In the Catholic epistle today, in Jude, it says, you beloved, building yourself on your most holy faith. In the gospel, in the morning, we talked about, I have come as a light into the world that whoever believes in me should not abide in darkness. In John 12. And actually, if we are paying attention in a Synaxarian, talked about that St. Mina the monk, who was telling him, like, hey, whoever believes that Jesus has life, and whoever doesn't believe in Jesus does not have life. So even the Synaxarium, which is obviously a coincidence today, talked about belief. And then yesterday we talked about, you search the scriptures, for in them you have an everlasting life, but if you do not believe his writings, how will you believe my words? So the first thing that the readings are focusing, are pointing us to, is this belief. Belief. Not about the earth being flat, not about like moms having, you know, eyes in the back of their head or watermelon seeds, but true belief in the Eucharist. Well, what else does it point to? In the Acts and the Hebrews, it talks about something else. In the Acts that we read, on the first day of the week, when the disciples came together to break bread. So obviously, if we're talking, focusing on the Eucharist, that's a great passage to read. But they came together. They came together as well. And then in the Pauline epistle in Hebrews, we read, for we become partakers of Christ, and if we behold the beginning of our confidence steadfast to the end. So basically, partake. Come together and partake. Believe and partake. Believe and partake. Those are the two things we just want to mention. So believe. You say, well, I'm here. I'm here on a Sunday morning. I got my rear end out of my bed, and I'm here. I must mean I believe. Yeah, there is a sense of belief. But believe, let's talk about three things that maybe we can help us believe. And again, if you haven't opened up your apps, it's a good chance to kind of engage ourselves and to remind ourselves of, like, how do I want to enter and benefit of the Holy Eucharist as much as I can. So if I believe, I prepare. If I believe that in about 30 minutes, I'm going to have the Son of God, I'm going to have God inside me, if I really believe this, then I need to prepare. And we all look, and then this is no shaming or anything. Let's just go back about 12 hours. What were we doing 12 hours ago? Can we say that what I did 12 hours ago was the best way to prepare for the Son of God to be inside me? Was it the best way? Is my Saturday night honoring God? Is my Saturday night basically saying, I am preparing this body, this physical body, to somehow have the incorruptible body of God inside me? If I believe, I prepare, right? And of course, I'm going to always put in a plug for our Vespers and our praises, because they're not very well attended. Even though I know, like, Saturday nights are hard, but even if we could try every once in a while to attend and try to see a difference, try to see the difference of you at 10:45, when you have the body inside you, coming to Vespers versus not coming. All I say is just challenge. It's a challenge. Just come and see if it makes a difference. So if I believe, I prepare. If I believe, my behavior is consistent with my belief. If I say I believe, right, we don't say it's just words, right? As St. James said, like, even the demons believe, right? Like, I don't think anybody want to be at the same level as the demons. It doesn't sound very attractive. Like, if we just say we believe, that puts us at the same level, because the devils believe. The devils even believe in the power of God, right? And we know that from the stories. When, you know, like, when they cast out a demon today, hey, I know you're going to cast us out. Can we go there? Like, they know they have the power of Jesus casting them out, even where? So my belief has to have the behavior following my belief. If I believe in the Son of God, and I believe in his humility, and I believe in him and the way he acts, then my belief in him has to correspond to my behavior in him as well. If I believe that truly this is the Son of God, that truly that he is alive, he really resurrected, if I truly believe, then I have to be in relationship with him. I don't worship a dead God. I worship a living God. And a living God is one we have a relationship with, one we have conversation with, one we have a daily time with. So now, when we said, yeah, do we believe in the Eucharist? All of us probably would have said 100% yes. But we want to put these three tests before I really, really put, like, a punctuation mark to it. I believe, right? And this is what we pray, right? I say it first, I believe, I believe, I believe. The deacon will say, I believe, I believe, I believe. This is our confession at the end. We all say it. And they're saying, you're saying it too, that this is the holy body. We believe. Belief cannot be lip service. Belief cannot come out of our mouth. Yes, it could start there because, you know, it's good. It's good to kind of get us there. But these are three indications. If I believe, I prepare. Look at our Saturday nights. Look at our Sunday mornings, right? How, like, do I just snooze 3-4 times and then just kind of gradually stroll into church? Or am I up and maybe even praying? Maybe even reading? Maybe preparing by, like, we send the readings every single week, right? We send out the readings of this so that we can be prepared. That's a good way to prepare. So prepare my behavior and my ongoing relationship with him. This is a test. This is a fruit. If I believe, then these three have to be in there. And these are not the only three, but these three must be incorporated. If I say I believe, and when I cry out and we all encourage ourselves, that's why it's sometimes we say I believe, and sometimes we say we believe, right? It's a personal conviction, and then it's a communal conviction together. The second thing from the readings after believe is partake. Okay, if you believe, then come. 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 Partake. Partake. Partake regularly. Partake expectantly. If I believe that this has, and we'll see what all this thing, you know, maybe we'll read it first. If I believe that this bread of God is the only food that can satisfy when we are faced with affliction, as St. Ignatius said, I believe, according to St. Cyril of Alexandria, he said the human being who had been created for eternal life is now given the power over death. This is all commentary about the Eucharist, about the Holy Communion. So the power over death. I believe, again, St. Cyril of Alexandria, the further through our sealing with the blood of Christ, we distance ourselves from the destroyer. The further we come in union with him, the closer we are him, the further we distance ourselves from our tempter, the accuser, the devil himself. The further we are. And again, do we want to be close to the devil? Do we want to be far from the devil? And St. Gregory the theologian said, it becomes a weapon against us. The war against us, and it strengthens the weak. How many times do we say, look, I'm too weak. I'm too weak. I can't overcome lust. I can't overcome anger. I can't overcome gossip. I just love it. I can't overcome just laziness. I can't overcome. I can't. Then you don't know, you don't believe, and then you don't partake regularly and expectantly. This today has the power, according to our church fathers, of all these, the power to satisfy our soul, where we look at everything else to satisfy, and it says, it's right here, on this table, on this table. As the power over death has the power to keep us close to him and further from Satan. And it has a power as a weapon against all the things that we struggle against. So what should I do? Partake regularly. If I know this, would I partake once a month? If I know this, would I find ways to come as any liturgy that I can attend to try to come to frequent? And by the way, we are at sea, and we'll put this in the announcement, but we have, you know, we'll have liturgies every single Wednesday from now till Easter, right? This is going to be the Feast of the Ninevites, or the Fast of the Ninevites. So we'll have and then, of course, the Great Fast. So every liturgy, partake regularly. Partake regularly. If I believe, by preparing, by behavior, by my relationship with him, then come and partake. And come and partake expectantly. Come and expect something. Don't come just in the communion line, just follow, it's a routine. Come and receive, like you are expecting power. You're expecting something to come, something to change in you. But that's my faith, that's my coming expectantly. Two words today, that's it. Two words to remember, believe and partake. Believe and partake. But we sowed the criteria of belief, and we sowed why you should partake. And to partake, come regularly and come expectantly. And then we should say as the disciples, as he said in verse 34 in John chapter 6, Lord, Lord, give us this bread always. And glory be to God forever. Amen.
God, let us attend. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, truly.
We believe in one God, God the Father, the Pontificator, creator of heaven and earth, and all things seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and of the Virgin Mary and became man. And he was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate, suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose from the dead, according to the Scriptures, ascended into the heavens. He sits at the right hand of his Father, and he is coming again in his glory to judge the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. Yes, we believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, and with the Father the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets, and of one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church, we confess and baptism for the remission of sin.
We look for the resurrection.
I've sinned, forgive me. Pray.
Stand up for prayer.
Peace be with all.
And with your spirit.
O God, the great, the eternal, who formed man in incorruption, and death which entered into the world through the envy of the devil, you have destroyed by the life-giving manifestation of your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ. You have filled the earth with a heavenly peace by which the host of angels glorify you, saying, glory to God in the highest, peace on earth and goodwill toward man.
Pray for perfect peace, love, and the holy apostolic greetings.
Lord,
according to your goodwill, O God, fill our hearts with your peace. Cleanse us from all blemish, all guile, hypocrisy, all craftiness, and the remembrance of vice bearing death. And make us all worthy our master to greet one another with a holy kiss, that without casting us into condemnation, we may partake of your immortal and heavenly gift. In Christ Jesus our Lord.
Greet one another with a holy kiss. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Yeah, Lord, who are Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Hear us now, mercy on us. Offer, offer, in order, stand with trembling. Look towards these, let us attend.
Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, Saint Mary, O Lord, grant.
with you all.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord.
It is meet and right.
Meet and right, meet and right. Truly indeed it is meet and right. O you the being, Master Lord, creator of heaven and earth and all things, being the Master Lord, who before the ages, who reigning forever, who dwells in the highest and looks upon the lowly, who has created the heaven, the earth, the sea, and all that is therein, the Father of our Lord, God and Savior, Jesus Christ, by whom ye create all things visible and invisible, who is seated upon the throne of his glory, and is worshipped by all the holy powers.
You who are seated, stand.
Before him stand the angels, the archangels, the principalities, the authority, the throne, dominions, and the powers.
Look towards the east.
You are he. Around him stand a cherubim full of eyes and a seraphim with the six wings, praising continuously without ceasing, saying,
let us attend. Formed us, created us, and placed us in the paradise of joy. When we disobeyed the commandment by the deceit of the serpent, we fell from eternal life and were exiled from the paradise of joy. You have not abandoned us to the end, but have always visited us through your holy prophets. And in the last days you manifested yourself to us, who were sitting in darkness and the shadow of death, through your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who of the Holy Spirit and of the Holy Virgin Mary.
Amen.
Was incarnate and became man and taught us the ways of salvation. He granted us the birth from on high through water and spirit. He made us unto himself and assembled people and sanctified us by your Holy Spirit. He loved his own who are in the world, and as a ransom on our behalf gave himself up unto death, which reigned over us, whereby our man and soul on account of our sins he descended into Hades through the cross.
Amen. Amen.
He rose from the dead on the third day and ascended into the heavens and sat at your right hand, O Father. He has appointed a day for recompense on which he'll appear to judge the world in righteousness and give each one according to his deeds.
According to your mercy, O Lord, and not according to our sins.
He instituted for us this great mystery of godliness for being determined to give himself up to death for the life of the world.
We believe.
He took bread into his holy hands, which are without spot or blemish, blessed and life-giving.
We believe.
Up towards heaven to you, God, who are his Father, Master of everyone. And when he had given thanks,
Amen.
He blessed it.
Amen.
He sanctified it. The saints and disciples and holy apostles, saying, take, eat of it, all of you, for this is my body, which is broken for you and for many, to be given for the remission of sins. This do in remembrance of me.
This is true.
Likewise also the cup after supper, he mixed it of wine and water, and when he had given thanks,
Amen.
He blessed it,
Amen.
He sanctified it. Saying to disciples and holy apostles, saying, take, drink of it, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, to be given for the remission of sins. This do in remembrance of me.
This is
eat of this bread and drink of this cup, you proclaim my death, confess my resurrection, and remember me till I come.
Amen, 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 your death, O Lord, we proclaim your holy resurrection and ascension into the heavens. We confess, we
as we also commemorate his holy passion, his resurrection from the dead, his ascension into the heavens, his sitting at your right hand, O Father, and his second coming from the heavens, awesome and full of glory, we offer unto you a gift from what is yours for everything, concerning everything, and in everything.
Worship God in fear and trembling. Satana. Amen.
This bread he makes into his holy body. And this cup also, the precious blood of his new covenant. Given for the remission of sins and eternal life to those who partake of him.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Then we ask you, O Christ our God, confirm the foundation of the church.
Lord,
the oneness of heart that is love, may it take root in us. May the righteousness of faith grow, straighten for us the way of godliness.
Lord, have mercy.
Control the shepherds and those whom they shepherd, confirm. Give splendor to the clergy, asceticism to the monks and nuns.
Lord, have mercy.
Purity to those in virginity, a life of goodness to those in wedlock. Mercy to those in repentance, goodness to the rich.
Lord, have mercy.
Meekness to the honorable, help to the poor. Strengthen the elders, chasten the young.
Lord, have mercy.
Restore the unbelievers. May the schisms of the church cease. Strip the vanity of the heretics and count us all in the unity of godliness.
Lord, have mercy.
So we're there, Master, to partake of your holies unto the purification of our souls, bodies, and spirits, that we become one body, one spirit, may have a share and inheritance with all the saints who have pleased you since the beginning. Remember, O Lord, the peace of the one only holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
Lord, have mercy.
This which you require yourself with the precious blood of your Christ, keep her in peace with all the Orthodox bishops who are in her. Foremost, remember, Lord, the blessed honor, Father, the Patriarch, Pope Abba Tuadris II, and a spiritual brother, the Patriarch of Antioch, Marinatus Ephraim II.
Lord, have mercy.
And those who rightly honor the word of truth of them, grant them unto your holy church to shepherd your flock in peace. Remember, Lord, the Orthodox Higgins priests and deacons.
Lord, have mercy.
And all your servants and all who are in virginity and the purity of your faithful people, remember, O Lord, to have mercy upon us all.
Have mercy upon us, O God, the Father, the Pantocrator.
Remember, O Lord, the salvation of this your holy place and every monastery of Orthodox fathers. Those who dwell therein in God's faith, graciously accord to bless the air, the heaven, the fruits of the earth, the waters of the river, the seeds, the herbs, and the plants of the field this year.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy.
Raise them to their measure according to your grace. Give joy to the face of the earth. May its furrows be abundantly watered and its fruit be plentiful. Prepare it for sowing and harvesting. Manage our life as deemed fit. Bless the crown of the year, the goodness of the sake of the poor, your people, the widow, the orphan, the traveler, the stranger, and for the sake of all of us who entreat you and seek your holy name. For the eyes of everyone wait upon you, for you have given their food in due season. Deal with us according to your goodness, so you give food to all flesh. Fill our hearts with joy and gladness, that we too, having sufficiency in everything always, may abound in every good deed.
Lord, have mercy.
Healing to the sick, rest to the needy.
Lord, have mercy.
Release those in captivity, acceptance to the orphans. Help to the widows, satisfy the distress with good things.
Lord, have mercy.
Raise the fallen, confirm the upright. Remember those who have fallen asleep, accept to yourself the prayers of the confessors.
Lord, have mercy.
The sinners who have repented, count them with your faithful, your faithful. Count them with your martyrs. Those who are in this place, confirm them to your angels, and we also have been called by your grace into your service. While unworthy, accept us to yourself.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, Lord, those who have brought unto you these gifts, those on whose behalf they have been brought, and those by whom they have been brought. Give them all the heavenly reward.
Pray for these holy and precious gifts, our sacrifices, and those who bring them.
Lord,
O Lord, is the command of your only begotten Son, that we share in a commemoration of your saints. Graciously remember all the saints who have pleased you since the beginning. Our holy fathers, the patriarch, the prophet, the apostles, the preachers, the evangelists, the martyrs, the confessors, and all the spirits of the righteous, perfected in the faith. Most of all, the pure, full of glory, ever virgin, holy Theotokos, Saint Mary, who truly gave birth to God, the Logos, and St. John, a former Baptist and martyr, St. Stephen, the Arcean and Porter martyr, the beholder of God, the evangelist, Mark, the holy apostle and martyr, the patriarch, St. Severus, our teacher, the Oscar, St. Athanasius, the apostolic, St. Peter, the holy martyr and high priest, St. John, Chrysostom, St. Theodosius, St. Theophilus, St. Demetrius and Cyril, St. Basil, St. Gregory, theologian, St. Gregory the Wonder Worker, and St. Gregory the Armenian, the 318 at Smyrna, 150 at Constantinople, the 200 at Ephesus, our righteous father, the great Abba Anthony, the righteous Abba Paul, the three saints of Macari, and all their children, the crossbearers, our father, Abba John Nehigaman, our father, Abba Shoy, the perfect man, the beloved of our good Savior, our father, Abba Paul, Timon, Ezekiel's disciples, my Lord's the Roman's father, St. Maximus and Damasus, the 49 martyrs, the elders, the Shahid, the strong St. Abba Moses, John Kama, the priest. Our father, Abba Daniel, the Higaman, our father, Isidore, the priest. Our father, Abba Bahoma, the Kanonia, and Theodore, his disciple. Our father, Abba Shanu, the Yershaman, right, and Ambawisa, his disciple. And all the choir of your saints, through whose prayers and supplications, have mercy on us all and save us for the sake of your holy name, which is called upon us.
Let those who read recite the names of our holy fathers, the patriarchs who have fallen asleep. O Lord, repose their souls and forgive us our sins.
May they
mention those we have not mentioned, those whom each one of us has in mind, and those who are not in mind, who have fallen asleep and repose in the faith of Christ. Graciously, O Lord, remember, O Lord, your servants, Meribeth Hopi, Mona Marid, Ezzat Salib Naum, Salib, Salib. Graciously, O Lord, repose all the souls in the bosom of our holy fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Sustain them in green pasture beside the still water, rest in the paradise of joy, the place out of which grief, sorrow, and groaning have fled away. In the light of your saints, keep an eye on them. Oh, 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 Lord, whose souls you have taken, repose them in the paradise of joy. In the region of the living forever, in heavenly Jerusalem, in that place. And we too, who are sojourners in this place, keep us in your faith and grant us your peace unto the end. Throughout the way into your kingdom, that as in it, so also in all things your great and holy name may be glorified, blessed, and exalted in everything. Honor and blessed with Jesus Christ, your beloved Son, and the Holy Spirit. Peace be with all. Again, let us give thanks to God, the Pontifex Creator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ. For he has made us worthy now to stand in this holy place, to lift up our hands, and to serve his holy name. Let us also ask him to make us worthy of communion, partaken of his divine and immortal mysteries. Holy body,
we worship your holy body
in the precious His blood. Is Christ the Pantocrator, the Lord our God.
Amen, amen. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Peace be with all. O Master, Lord our God, the great, the eternal, who is wondrous in glory, who keeps his covenant and his mercy for those who love him with all their hearts, who has given to us redemption of sin through his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, the life of everyone. The help of those who flee to him, the hope of those who cry out to him, before whom stand thousands and thousands and 10,000 times a thousand of your holy angels and archangels, the cherubim and the seraphim, and all the innumerable hosts of the heavenly powers. O God, you have sanctified these gifts which are sent forth through the coming down upon him of your Holy Spirit. You have purified them. Purify us also, our Master, from our sins, the hidden and manifest, and every thought not pleasing to your goodness, O God, the lover of mankind, may it be far from us. Purify our souls, our bodies, our spirits, our hearts, our eyes, our understanding, our thoughts, and our consciences, that with a pure heart and enlightened soul, unashamed countenance of faith and fear, and a perfect love and a firm hope, we may dare with boldness, without fear, to pray to God the Holy Father in heavens and say, Our Father.
In the fear of God, amen.
Peace be with all.
And with your spirit.
Thank you, Lord, for giving us, O Lord, your holy body and your precious blood. Help us, O Lord, truly see if truly we believe in this. Help us, O Lord, recognize, O Lord, our belief has to come with preparation. Come, O Lord, with the relationship with you, and come with good behavior at all times. And not only stop at belief, but let us come and partake regularly and expectantly, O Lord, knowing that this gives us our weapon, our power, O Lord, distances us from the destroyer, and gives us, O Lord, satisfaction at all times. Remember, O Lord, our assemblies, bless them.
Save our men, and with your spirit and the fear of God, let us attend.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
The holies for the holies. Blessed be the Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, the sanctification by the Holy Spirit. Amen.
What is the Holy Father? What is the Holy Son? What is the Holy Spirit? Amen.
Peace be with all.
And with your spirit.
The holy body and precious true blood of Jesus Christ, Son of our God. Amen. Holy and precious body and true blood of Jesus Christ, the Son of our God. Amen.
Amen.
The body and blood of Emmanuel, our God, this is true. Amen.
Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. I believe and confess to the last breath that this is the life-giving flesh of your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, who took from our Lady, the Lady of us all, the Holy Theotokos, St. Mary. He made it one with divinity, without being, without confusion, without alteration. He confessed the good confession before Pontius Pilate. He gave it for us upon the holy wood of the cross of his own will for us all. Truly, I believe. Let the divinity pardon not from his humanity for a single moment or a twinkling of an eye, given for us for salvation, remission of sins, and eternal life to those who partake of him. I believe that this is true. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. I believe. I believe that this is so in truth. Amen. Pray for us and for all Christians who said to us concerning them, remember us in the house of the Lord. The peace and love of Jesus Christ be with you. Sing praise. Alleluia. Pray for the worthy communion of the Immaculate Heavenly and Holy Mysteries. Lord, have mercy.
Glory to you, O Lord. Glory to you.
O Lord, author of life and King of the ages, Jesus Christ, the living bread, who came down from heaven and who granted life to those who partake of your holy body and honored blood, grant your servant your heavenly blessings in order to be worthy to approach the mystery of your holy body and blood in godliness and reverence. Alert my heart to your grace and visit me with your salvation, that I may taste the sweetness of your heavenly grace, hidden in time in this all holy mystery. Grant me a strong faith, free from doubt and skepticism, that I may approach you now, trusting that this is your holy body and precious blood. O Emmanuel, our God, make me worthy to partake of them without falling into condemnation, in order to be united with you spiritually, and for the forgiveness of my sins, and for my acceptance before awesome judgment. Through the voice of the glory of the good Father and the Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Church believe that truly this is the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, given for the remission of sins and eternal life to those who partake of him, and invites everyone down to partake of this mystery. All those who have practiced regular repentance and confession, and all those who are practicing any steps towards forgiveness, all those who attended the liturgy of the word and are baptized in the Orthodox faith. If we're not baptized or if we're not ready yet, please come and receive a blessing from the body himself. The holy for the holies, blessed be the Lord Jesus Christ, Son of our God, sanctification by the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Blessed is you, comes the name of the Lord.
Body and blood of Emmanuel, God, this is true. Amen.
Blessed is you, comes the name of the Lord. Oh,
O angel of the sacrifice flying up to the highest, remember us before our Lord, that he may forgive us our sins. Christ our God.
Amen, so be it.
O King of peace, grant us your peace, establish us your peace, and forgive us our sins. For yours the power, the glory, the blessing, the might, forever amen. Our Lord, make us worthy to pray thankfully. Our Father, who art in heaven, you just have a seat just for a few announcements and we'll get right to breakfast right after that. Is there a list? So first thing we want to do is, of course, always welcome our guests of the day. And we have a long list today. So we have Catherine Youssef coming back from California, but coming back with a nice gift, baby Sophia. So congratulations on the birth of your daughter. We also have Ashley Elliott visiting us from Houston. Is Ashley still here? All right. I thought your name was Sam.
Yeah, it's not Christian.
Oh, okay. Got me confused. Welcome, Ashley. Ashley joined us with Vespers last night as well. We have George Salama from the Chicago area. Is George? Hi, George. And we have Meher and Margaret from Egypt. Wow. All right. All the way. Thank you for visiting us. We have Amir Tedros visiting us from California, visiting Christine. And we also have Gina Hanna, who moved to Chicago. Is Gina here? Where is Gina? Welcome. So all the way from the suburbs, welcome to the city. We also have Alexander Gadino. Alexander, welcome. We have Peter Youssef and Tino Solomon. Thanks, and also they joined us for Vespers last night as well, from the Tampa area and from California. And then we have not new visitors, but even though it's been a while, I think, is this the first time you've been here as a married couple? So first time here as a married couple, of course they moved away, but Myrna and Mina Misael, so congratulations on last year's wedding. welcome back. And they're visiting us from Michigan. So at St. Paul's, if our mission here is to become a healthy church, healthy spiritually needs to have a vision, and our vision is to love God, to welcome everyone, and to make a difference in our own lives and the lives around us. And we do this again by our four pillars that hopefully you have memorized from now. And a healthy church, we said, a healthy church has to have confession as a prime part of their spiritual life. So every week we talk about a little bit about it, and we're just taking like a minute of time on first starting with the why. We're going to get to the what and how to confess, but before that, we have to understand the why. Why should I even think that this is a way to health, a way to the vision of this church? Well, we said the first reason it gives us healing, it gives us freedom, and it gives us forgiveness. Today, we want to talk about the fourth reason why. Why should I even confess? Because of cleansing. As we said in our theme verse of the year, if we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us. We all need a cleansing, right? We all need a cleansing. Think of the time when you're just hot, you're just messy, and that shower is so refreshing. Think of confession as always refreshing. It cleanses. As we say every day, multiple times a day in Psalm 50 or Psalm 51, wash me thoroughly from my iniquity and cleanse me from my sin. So why should I confess? Why should I confess? To have cleansing of my sins. And again in 1 John, if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another, and the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us. If we want cleansing, if we want this aspect of being clean, clean and pure, let's make sure that we include confession in our spiritual practices. Rest of the announcements. Cornerstone is back for a short mini-series on addiction, a deeper dive. I know we talked generally before in the fall about like our mental health and stuff like that, and we talked about addiction as a concept, but we're digging deeper, and we're talking about two addictions. This week, we have Monica Bugdaddy, who will talk about the addiction of pornography. So that's right after breakfast, and that will be our first addiction that we will be discussing. Monday, tomorrow, we have our usual Five Loaves Ministry. So if you want to help in preparing the food and giving out the food and buying the food, any of that stuff, please reach out to Yusuf Tenyos. I didn't see him today, but I'm sure he's going to be with us tomorrow. And obviously, like maybe the needs are going to change as the weather changes, but definitely all this warm stuff is still required in a city. Tuesday, we have our continuing our basics of orthodoxy at 7:30. Online is available as well. Just look at the link in the newsletter. And we are in our fourth week. And even if you need a refresher, and especially this one is probably the most important one. We talk about the sacraments and how they fit in our lives. So even if we want to just jump into the sacraments and don't even tune out, it's probably worth it to understand what the sacraments do for me. We have our one-on-one right after that at 8:30. And then we have our monthly parenting. Our monthly parenting is about like how do we make our children grow in independence? How do we make our children grow in independence? So this is like from age 2 onwards, right? Every year is a different level of independence in your child's life. So we'll be talking about that Tuesday at 9. Tomorrow the bell rings, right? Jonah's fast is the bell. So it always lets us know that the Lent is 2 weeks away. So we have a 3-day fast of the highest degree. So no, it's a completely vegan diet, Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday. And then Wednesday, we're going to have our liturgy from 5:30 to 7:30. All right? So all those who are like nearby or can make it, so come join us Wednesday from 5:30 to 7:30. And for those, of course, the young adults, AP is going to be doing his talk at 8 o'clock after that. Hopefully you can join us. If anybody has questions on fasting, because I know it's very, very late, just reach out to me, all right? Like I say, do not let fasting be a reason to not come to the liturgy. And then coming very, very soon, we're almost March is next week. So end of March, Mina and Monica are organizing a mission trip to Zambia. So actually they're here today. So I don't know how late we are into this planning, but probably this might be the last time we have to announce this. As an extra incentive, St. Paul's is subsidizing 50% of whatever it costs to go on this mission trip as well. So if you have that time, that flexibility, that would be great. So we'll see you downstairs. There was one more thing, but that's okay. It'll come to me. May the love of God the Father, grace of his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, communion gift of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Go in peace. May the peace of the Lord be with you.
Yeah. No, literally.